Welcome to a video that will show you how to determine sequences and series on the TI83 or 84 graphing calculator. Let's first take a look at how to generate sequences. If we're on the home screen, if we press second list and then right arrow once to ops or OPS, we want to select option 5 for sequence. Now we type in the formula that will generate the sequence. Let's say the formula is 5n minus 2. Instead of n, we'll use x. We'll type in 5x minus 2, comma. Next, we type in the variable that we're using, which is x, comma. And let's say we want the first 8 terms of this sequence. We press 1, comma, 8, and then a close parenthesis, and then we press enter. And it generates the sequence for us. And you can see on the right of the screen, there's a dot, dot, dot. That means there's more terms over there. So if we press the right arrow, we can see the rest of the terms in the sequence. Now let's say we want to find the sum of the series generated by this same sequence. If we press second list and then arrow over to the math menu, we'll see the sum option as option 5. Press 5. We want to sum a sequence, so now we have to go back and select the sequence function. So we press second list, and that was under the ops menu, so right arrow once, and then option 5 again. And then we type in the formula, which we said was 5x minus 2, comma, the variable x, comma. Again, we're looking for the sum of the first 8 terms, so 1, comma, 8. We have a closed parenthesis here for sequence, and then we have to have another one for the sum function. So there's 2 closed parentheses here on the end. We press enter, and there is the sum of that series. Now we can also find the sum of a sequence if it's listed as terms in a similar fashion. If we press second list, remember the sum function is under the math menu and the sequence function is under the ops menu. So we want sum, so we'll go over to the math menu, select option 5. Let's say we have a list of terms that we want to find the sum of. If we press second open parenthesis, we can just list the terms this way too. So if we had 2, comma, 4, comma, 6, comma, 8, second close parenthesis, and then another close parenthesis for the sum, it'll also find the sum this way, as we see there. So here's how we can check all of the work that we did by hand in the previous videos. I hope you found this explanation helpful.